Okay, what is going on today, guys? Your boy new winner 69420 Ryan here. We have an all four gauntlet upgrade, an unupgraded guide right here. I'm gonna show you all 20 dormant hands. There's one right there in that crystal in the intersection of treasuries. There's one of the dormant hand locations. Just knife it. It's not there in the game. There's also a second location right here by these flowers. It's not there in the game, as you see. But these are the locations you need to be checking. The third location, there'll be a pot right here in the Stoa of Athenians. It's not there in my gameplay. There's one more here in the Stoa of Athenians, and it's this pot, and this is where it happens to be my game right here. Just melee it and pick up the dormant. You need the dormant hand to start quest lines for the gauntlets. We're going down into the Spartan Monument. There's one that sits right here. It's not in my game, but check it, guys. There's one right here in the Spartan Monument, and there it is. See, it emits like a purple glow. Just look for the purple glow. There's up to 20 locations, and there's four hands, so just check these locations. There's one right here. Check this location. And there's one more in the Spartan Monument, I think, right here. Check this location, guys. And then right here, purple glow, there's another dormant hand. And I think that should conclude all the dormant hands inside of the map until you take Pegasus to the secret location. Here's a location for one more dormant hand. Check right here, guys. Checking this pile of mud right here for another dormant hand. When you open up to the cliff ruins, check right by the blue flame. Right here, look for another dormant hand. And if it's not there, go over to this buildable bench. It'll be right here. Just check around it, okay. If it's not there, check by the Eagle's Cage for Pack Punch. There's a location there as well. And if it's not there, continue to the center of the world. Look over here by the these bricks. There's a location here as well. Okay, and continue on over to right next to the center of the world, right next to Oranus's shrine. There should be one right there in that mud. Go up here to where the portal to leave. Once you do Pack-a-Punch and everything, there should be one right here too. That's another location. Open up this door, heading into Python's Pass, right by the trap of these crystals. There's a location for a dormant hand here as well. And if it's not here, guys, go ahead and check right here by the Titan wall by. There's another dormant hand location. And last but not least, the last dormant location, the 20th location, is right here next to the Karen shrine. And it happens to be my gameplay right there. You've seen it right there, the purple glow. That's all 20 locations. You check all 20. There's only four there. But we're going to start upgrading or getting the gauntlets now. The first gauntlet we're going to get is the Gauntlet of Gaia. Just come to her shrine, which is located in Spartan Monument, and hold square on this. Once you have a dormant hand, it should let you come here, and you'll be locked in this little green circle. Just kill some zombies for about 45 to 50 seconds, specifically the green glowing ones. And sure enough, as soon as you start killing enough, you'll be able to pick up the gauntlet, the base variant. Little gameplay, guys. And there it is. I finished the ritual, and now I can pick up the gauntlet. Now it's time to upgrade the Gauntlet of Gaia. And she has probably what I think is the easiest upgrade quest line. All you gotta do is locate these three plants with the red crystals on them. There's one right here in the intersection of treasuries next to the auger wall by right there. If you see the auger wall by in the intersection of treasuries, just shoot the gauntlet at the plant, the three crystals, and it'll drop a little seedling you gotta pick up, and you gotta take it right back to Gauntlet Gaia shrine in the Spartan Monument.
The closest I ever came to horticulture was gunning down a crime boss in his own greenhouse.
Pretty simple stuff, right? You just take the plant right to her. We got two more though, okay? So I'm gonna go to the second plant, which is located in the Stoa of Athenians, I believe. We'll see. And like I said, same process, just shoot the plant with the gauntlet, the three crystals, you know, and then grab the seedling and take it to her shrine that's located in Spartan Monument. And when you do have the plant, you cannot shoot, and you are kind of slower on the slower side, so please be careful. If you're running, with multiple players, just have one of them cover you. You should be fine, but nothing too tricky. We're just taking back our second seedling. There we go. And the third one is in Temple Terrace. The third plant is right outside of spawn. Shoot it. The three crystals again. Rinse and repeat. Pick up the seedling. Take it back to Gaia. And you realize that she's satisfied. And you can enter a portal where you prove yourself. All three plants, portal open, jump in the portal, and you'll be taken to this outside a place that is kind of like not in the map. You can't get here unless you do this trial. And basically you have unlimited gauntlet, you have the upgraded version, just kill here for about 45 to 50 seconds and then you'll have a portal that'll let you leave, and you basically have the upgraded weapon, so there you guys go. Upgraded Gaia gauntlet, I guess, not the technical name for it, but there you go. Obviously, I did skip around the footage that you'll be fighting for more than 10 seconds, I promise. It's like 40 or 50. There you go, upgraded gauntlet. We're gonna move on to the second one. So the second one is located, this is the Oranus, I think it's pronounced, the Wind Gauntlet, and it's located in the center of the world. Get your one of the Dormant Hands from one of the 20 locations and come to the statue and begin the same kind of deal. You're in the lockdown, you gotta kill the blue zombies for 45 seconds in the circle. Just kill some blue zombies. Sorry if the commentary is really whack. I'm new to this whole guide scheme, so I appreciate it if you dropped a like or anything. Like I said, just stay in this circle and murder some zombies, you know, for a couple seconds. And then you'll be granted the Oranus Gauntlet, the Wind Gauntlet. There we go, we got ourselves the gauntlet, good stuff. Now time to upgrade it, guys. So what we gotta do is there's three feathers down here in this location where Pegasus takes you, pack a bunch of, and you gotta shoot a zombie at those feathers. See that little arrow? And now you gotta shoot the feather with the gauntlet twice to get it to the Oranus shrine. It's right there, I hit it two times, the feather lands at the shrine. Okay, first one here at Sun of the World is where the arrow is. Now the second one is at Python's Pass. See that big arrow? Now I gotta shoot the zombie at it. Okay, look, boom, hits the feather, and you gotta hit the shrine twice, and boom, the feather makes it there. And if you look closely, the little arrow that you shot the zombie comes down, letting you know that you've completed that one. Moving on to the third one, which is located at Cliff Ruins. Just shoot your zombie at it, shoot the feather twice with your gauntlet, and then it should land at the shrine. Once you've had all three feathers at the shrine, you'll be able to go to his portal and do his challenge. Same concept, go to the portal and destroy a bunch of zombies with an infinite gauntlet, and then when you leave the portal, you'll have the upgraded gauntlet of Oranus, the Wind Gauntlet. So there you go. Yeah, here we go, some action with it. I figured you guys probably want to see the gauntlet in action, all the gameplay. This is the Wind Gauntlet. This is a really cool one, I think. So just kill some zombies, the portal will open. You'll be able to leave this area, and you have yourself the Gauntlet of Oranus. You guys upgraded one. Okay. Our next gauntlet is going to be, I'm pretty positive, yep, okay. It's the Gauntlet of, I think it's Karen? It's spelled with a CH though. And same concept. Come to his statue with a Dormant Hands and fight in the red circle, kill red zombies for 45 seconds, and then you'll be able to pick up the base variant of the gauntlet, you know what I mean? And this one I think by far is probably the most lethal one. It's the most useful, it kills a lot of zombies. You'll see once it's upgraded, it's an SOB, a badass SOB. So like I said, just kill some zombies. And then you'll be able to pick up the Gauntlet of Karen. Right here at Python's Pass. Yep, there we go. We got the Gauntlet. Cool. Now, the next thing you want to do is come to the Odin perk right here in the River of Sorrows and kill a bunch of zombies with the Gauntlet. Now, it doesn't need to be a lot. Like, I only had 15 bullets and I used all 15, and that's exactly how much I needed. Just kill them in the water. As you see, just start laying rest of the zombies. They all need to die. And then come to the water, and it'll hold square to drink from the water. That's how you know you've killed enough zombies. Just hold square, and then you'll be put in this, like, weird, like, trance, and you'll have, like, your screen will get really dark. You can't heal in this thing, and the whole point is that you need to run around this whole, like, part of the map, and you need to look for little orange dots. Some of them it'll say hold square to extinguish fake dot, and those are the ones that you're not looking for. You're looking for the ones that are gonna hold square to obtain, and there's nowhere to really tell. Just keep looking around this whole area. You'll see a bunch of dots. You'll pick them up, and I think you need three, and then once you have three, you will take them back to the shrine and give them to Karen, and you'll get the portal to open. But I'm going to show you what the ones you're looking for look like. Right there, it says hold, obtain, the coin. There you go, that's a good one. You're looking for the coins that aren't fake, so. And you'll see me deposit right here. Like I said, you're looking for three of them, so just run around the area, look for the dots, the correct ones, give three to the thing, and then it'll send you in this portal, okay? Once you get here, same process, just kill a bunch of zombies with your gauntlet, and you'll be fine. This is a nice gauntlet. Gauntlet of Karen. These names are really confusing. This tutorial, I don't know what the hell this is going to be. I hope it's not confusing. I bet it probably is, but like I said, if anyone needs help and doesn't understand the guide completely, you can always feel free to comment and I'll try to explain something to the best of my ability. But like I said, just kill some zombies here with the gauntlet while it has infinite ammo, and then a portal will open and you'll return to the map with the upgraded Gauntlet of Karen. I have shown you all 20 dormant hands. You've had three gauntlets made and upgraded. We have one gauntlet left, and that is the Gauntlet of Hemra, I think it is, and she's like the sun, a sun goddess. Okay. And how you're gonna get her gauntlet is you're gonna get a dormant hand from one of those 20 locations, and you're gonna come to the Monument of Craterus, and you are gonna, once again, do another lockdown. Gonna do another lockdown, and you just kill the yellow zombies while you're in the circle, and I just stay here, kill the zombies, don't die. I almost do in this gameplay. The Pegasus Strike is very useful, as you can see, while doing this. But once you've killed enough zombies and enough time has passed, you'll be able to pick up the Gauntlet of Hemra, and then once you have it, it's time to upgrade. Okay, now there's three locations around the map that have these little reflectors right here. Just shoot them a couple times. And every time you shoot it, shoot the gauntlet at it. So you just want to shoot it once with your gun, shoot it once with the gauntlet until you get the formula down. That's still not correct, obviously, so I shoot the plate one more time. I shoot the gauntlet at it. Still not right. So I shoot the gun at the plate again. And then look at the bounce. And it lands in that bowl right there. See the bowl? Now what we're going to do is we're going to come back to the bowl, okay? And we're going to pull our gauntlet out and melee the bowl. And it's going to pick up the light that we just reflected into the bowl. So there's the plate. Melee the bowl. Now you have the glow. Now you want to take that back to the shrine over here at the Monument of Craterus. You want to take it to Hemra's shrine. And melee the bowl over there. That's one of three, so you got to do that at two other locations. So there's one at the upper road. Just, you know, like I said, shoot that. And then shoot the gauntlet, and then you'll reflect it in the bowl, pick it up with the melee, you know, melee the bowl again, pick up the light, and take it back to the shrine again. You want to keep doing this, depositing your light. And the third location's at Temple Terrace, like I said, shoot the reflector, melee the bowl, pick up the light. And boom, once you've had all three lights, a portal will open up, and you will have to prove yourself to Hemra. Once again, taken to a secret location, and you'll have infinite ammo with the gauntlet. it's the upgraded gauntlet, and just survive 45 seconds or so, and you'll have you'll be get a portal to leave, and you'll have the upgraded gauntlet of Hemra. That's basically all. I'm gonna leave you guys with the gameplay. I hope the guide wasn't too confusing. If it is, I'm willing to answer questions in the comment section. Feel free to talk about it. We'll get a discussion going. If you guys want to play with me, my gamer tag is in the description as well. Feel free to add me on PlayStation. I'd be willing to play with subscribers. But that's all. You guys have a nice day. Bye, guys. Peace.
Feel the full force of my fist.
Hemra finds you worthy.